It is complete course project. Please learn them in order. It is part 3, lighting. Okay, now we want to light our scene. So I will close my outliner. So before you start lighting, you need to set camera view. So I will click spacebar. So that means you got the 4 views. So I want only 2 views. Here we want camera view. Here we want perspective view. So I will click and drag this one. So that means we got only 2 views. So now go to rendering tab and click on this one, create camera. So it will automatically created in center of grid. Press R and scale in mid. So now go to panels. So when the camera selected, go to panels, perspective, and choose camera 1. So that means you will able to see through the camera. So I will pan my view over here. See, my camera will be moved automatically when you pan over here. So like that. So go to view, camera settings, and give overscan. And go to view, camera settings, and give resolution gate. So this one is very high. When you start rendering, you want to keep very little amount of height and width, because when you keep 960 into 540, it takes huge time of render every time you hit render button. So I will go to render settings, and in common tab you definitely you want to choose 640 into 480. So and then close. So I will keep my camera close to this magnify glass over here. So like this. Okay. Okay. Now go to view. So I will manipulate a little bit closer. So go to view, select camera. When the camera selected, you want to lock this all attributes. So I will select all the attributes over here. Right click and choose lock selected. That means you cannot able to move this camera view. So now I want to select this here and click render button. So now I got only the Maya software render. So see here, I want to set my render view of mental ray. So before that, I will go to view and select camera and select the all the attributes. Right click and choose unlock selected, because I want to little bit turn over here. So I will little bit angle over here. So like this. Okay. So now, so we want to keep like this. So now I will view, select camera, and select all the attributes and right click and choose lock selector. So okay, now see here, I click this viewport over here and click render. So see here, we did not keep any light in our scene. So but still it will shows the light, because of go to render settings. In common tab, you definitely give render options, disable this enable default light. So I will uncheck this one. So that means when I click this view and click render, you cannot able to see anything. So this is what we want. We want to set the light manually. So before that, I want to render my settings as a mental ray. So in render settings, you want to choose render using as mental ray. Sometimes it will not available here. That means you want to enable in render settings. So sorry, settings preference. So go to window, settings preference, and choose plugin manager. And here you need to turn on Maya to MR. So load and auto load. That means it will available over here. So go to render settings and render using, choose mental ray. So now I click this scene and click render. So now you cannot able to see anything because we did not set any light in our scene. So now I want to hide this camera over here. So go to show and uncheck this one, cameras. So that means you cannot able to see the camera in perspective view. So now I want to set the key light using direction light. Go to rendering tab and choose direction light and press R in keyboard and scale this one. Press E and rotate in X like this. Press W. Now you want to move in Z over here on outside like this. So and then go to attributes and go to shadows and turn on this one, use ray trace shadow. So click this viewport and click render button. Okay, now you able to see the window cut over here. So I want rotate little bit, so I will click E button to rotate in X little bit like this. So I will rotate little bit like this. So and I will compare this one and click render again. So this is what I expect. So I will rotate little bit further, so like this, and keep this image for comparison and click render. So it looks perfect. See here, so I got somewhat reflections over here. Okay, so now we got that basic light setup over here. So now I want to set reflections for this scene. So now go to polygons and click on this polyplane and press R in keyboard and scale this one. So as big as possible. So I will scale like this and press W and move in up. Go to channel box and layer editor. So I want to give one divisions. So you want to rotate this one is a 180. So I will rotate this plane, give 180 and press W and move in up. So press R and scale little bit smaller. So like this, you want to cover the whole area. So now I want to bend this one. So shift right click and choose, right click and choose edge. Select any one of the edge, shift right click and choose insert edge loop. So I will insert edge loop in center and press W and move in Y. So and shift right click and choose insert edge loop again. So you want to insert edge loop over here and press W and move in Y. So double click on this edge, shift double click on this edge, shift right click and choose bevel edge. So you want to increase the fraction amount and segment. So right click and choose object mode. So now I want to apply surface shader over here. So right click and choose assign new material and choose surface shader. So in surface shader you want to give, so I will rename of REF reflection underscore surface shader 01 and press enter. So I will give out color to pure white like this. Now press Ctrl D and press E and rotate in X. So I will give minus 90 and press W and move in Z like this, and I want to move in Y like this. So I will move a little bit outside. So I will select this one and move a little bit upside. So now I want to select this object and press Ctrl D. I want to move this one. Press E and rotate in Y 90 degree. Press W and move in Z. So I want to cover this area. So now we got reflections for this object. So I will check this one. So select this viewport and click render. So now see, you got some reflections for this object, but it's too high, so I want to reduce this material attributes. So I will select this one and go to attributes editor. So now I want to go to magnify blend 1. So and then I want to reduce my reflectivity to 0.2, so it's enough. I want to reduce little bit specular color, so like this. So I will keep this image for comparison, so and click render button. So now I check this one. See, we have a lot of reflection, so I will reduce little bit. So now we want to turn on our final gathering for our scene lighting, so for bones. So I will keep this image for comparison. So I will go to render settings. So in mental ray, in quality tab, you definitely you want to turn on this one, show advanced settings. So that means it will show the final gathering option, legacy option. So if you uncheck this one, you cannot able to see the legacy option. So that means you want to definitely turn on this one and go to legacy option. So and go to bottom side, you will see the final gathering. Turn on this one. So that means when I click on this scene and click render, so see here our scene got some bounce over here, but it's too high, so I will compare this one. So it's too high, so I want to reduce the scene size, sorry, the reflection intensity. So I will select this surface shader material over here. So any one of this, select any one of this and go to reflection surface shader. I reduce my out color to 50% gray, so like this. So now I select this viewport, click this open render view. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render. Okay, I will compare this one. See, our scene's intense will decrease, so like this. So it's what we want. So now I want to increase my direction light intensity little bit. So I will select my direction light. So go to intensity. So I will give 2. So I will select this view. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render button again. Okay, it's okay. But so see here, our intensity will increase, but we have lot of bleach over here. So that means I want to adjust that ground material. So I will select this ground object over here. So right click and choose material attributes. So here right click and choose material attributes. So otherwise click this one and go over here. So you want to find floor blend. So select this one and go and find the floor blend over here. So at the end, so select this one. I want to adjust my specular color, reduce my specular color little bit, and I want to reduce little bit reflectivity to 0.3. so I will select this view. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render. So see here, I will got exactly what we need. So now I want to adjust this magnify glass. So that means select the magnify glass, so and go to ray trace option. So in magnify glass, so you want to rename this material. So glass_blend. So I will select my magnify glass and go to material attributes and rename my blend as glass_blend 01. So now I want to go to ray trace option and turn on this refraction. So I will give refractive index to 1.2. so I will keep this image for comparison. See here, now we have that the glass material is look through selected, sorry, look through exactly what we saw in backside. So if you turn on this refraction, so the light will be bent over here. So that means the magnified glass looks more realistic. So before that, go to render settings and go to trace depth. So here you need to go trace depth, and you here we need to give at least 5 refraction. So here you need to give 10. So that means 5 5, here you need to 10. So give 10 because we want to sum these two values. So now I keep this image for comparison and click render button. Okay, see here we have, so in previous frame we have we see exactly the back side of our scene. So from now when I turn on refraction, so the light will be bent, so it will looks like the magnified glass has zoom in. So it's really cool option. So when you turn on refraction, so it's normally set to 1 1, means it will be shown exactly on backside. So if you increase refractive index much more, so the light will be bent to this material, so it will looks like real magnified glass. So what this is what we expect. So now we want to work for our matchstick caustic patterns. So now I will keep this image for comparison. So I will close my render view. So now go to rendering and click on spotlight. So when the spotlight selected, so see here our spotlight selected, go to panels. So don't go over here, so go to panels over here and perspective and choose, sorry, go to panels and choose look through selector. So that means you will able to see through the light. So now you want to adjust the light. So as we navigate our scene, the light will be adjust. So you want to place exactly from the direction light. So you want to place exactly in the direction light area. So go to perspective. So now you able to see the light will be placed exactly where the direction light is placed. So now I doesn't want any intensity for this light. This only emit for caustics. So I will select my spotlight and give 0 intensity. Now go to mental ray option. So now go bottom side and turn on this caustics and global illumination. So if you click over here, you cannot able to see any caustics over here. So I will click render here. So I will select this view and click render button. So see here, you will not see any changes in this area. So that means go to render settings and go to quality tab. Here go in bottom side, here we have caustics. You want to turn on this caustics option over here. So now I click render. So see here our light pattern will be closed. So that means the caustics will be work now. So now I select the spotlight over here. So I will increase my photon intensity much more. So I will give 10,000 photons over here in intensity. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render again. Okay, so we will see what we have before and after. So nothing changes. So I want to increase much more intensity. So I will give 100,000 photons over here. So I will keep this image for comparison. So I'll click render again. Okay, so see here, you will see little bit light patterns over here. So this is what we expect, but I want to increase little bit intensity. So I will give 500,000 photon intensity. So I will keep this image and click render again. So see here, we will clearly see our pattern flow over here. So I want to increase little bit again, so I will give 800,000 photon. I will click render. So see, you have this pattern over here, so I will give much more. So I will give 1 million photons, so I will give 10 over here. So that means 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 lakh and 10 lakh photons over here. I will press enter. So now I keep this image and click render again. Okay, see here, it will be increased little bit. So I want to give 5 million photons over here, so I will increase. So and keep this image and click render again. So it's too high, see here. So I want to reduce little bit, so I will give 2 million photons, so I will click render. Okay, so see here, it's much better. So now I want to compare, keep this image. So now I want to see here, it will be the spotlight placement will be little bit mismatch. So I want to angle little bit. So go select the spotlight over here, go to panels and post, choose look through selector. So I want to angle little bit like this. So click and drag, pan the viewport. So I will keep this image and click render again. So now see, so the pattern will be angle little bit, so it will be exact. So now I want to tighten up this pattern. So now you want to increase this caustic photons. So I will give it in normal, it will be set to 10,000 photons. So I will give 50,000. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render again. So remember this one. So when you increase the caustic photons, so the render time will be cost huge time. So see here, in this case it has 36 seconds. So I will keep this image and click render. Okay, see here, now the caustic pattern is little bit tighten up. So this is what we expect, but see here our render time. So in previous render we got 36 frames, 36 seconds. So but now we got 41 seconds. So if you adjust caustic photons, it will takes render time much higher. So remember this one. So now I go to panels, perspective, and choose perspective. So I got exact placement for my spotlight. Now I want to reduce this one. So I select my spotlight, sorry, I will select my glass over here, go to glass blend over here. So now I want to adjust this pattern over here. So using go bottom side, so over this material and go to mental ray. So and I want to go to photon attributes, I uncheck this one, derive from Maya. So and click this button, take settings from Maya. So when I click means, so it will automatically take the Maya settings to this photon attributes. So you want to click over here, so uncheck this one and click this one. So now I want to see here, in refractive index I will give 1.2, so it will cause this pattern as big. So now I will give 1.4 and press enter. So see here, I will click keep this image for comparison and click render again. So see here, when we increase our ray tracing value, so the pattern will be tighten up over here. So I will increase much more, so I will give 1.6. so I will keep this image and click the render button again. Okay, so see here, the pattern will be tighten up. So I want to give 1.5. It's enough, I think. So I will give 1.5. So I will keep this image and click render. Okay, it's enough, I think. Now I want to little bit sharpen up our caustic pattern. So I will select my spotlight. So over here. So now I will give caustic photons to 80,000 photons. So I will keep this image and click render again. Okay, see here. So it will sharpen up our render over here. So now I want to go to window outliner. So select my matchstick group. So I want to move little bit. So press W. So I will select my matchstick group over here and press W and move in Z little bit and move little bit in X. So and keep this image for comparison and click render. Okay, see here, our matchstick is move over here. So I want move little bit further. So I want to move in Z. So little bit. So I will keep this image. So before that, I want to reduce little bit caustic's intensity. So I will select my spotlight and go to spotlight option. So I will give here 1. So 1 million photons. So I will keep this image and click render again. Okay, see here. So we got exactly what we need. So we will come closer to my lighting patterns. So I want to move little bit the matchstick group. So go to and choose matchstick group. So and move little bit in Z and keep this image for comparison and click render again. Okay, so see here, we got exact. So now I want to little bit increase my specular color for this front area. So I will select this front matchstick front. So right click and choose material attributes. So right click and choose material attributes. Now go to upside. You want to increase the specular color little bit higher. So like this. So I will keep this image for comparison and click render. Okay, so I will compare that one. So now see here, you will got little bit specular color over here. So I want to select my matchstick group and move little bit in Z. So further. So I will keep this image and click render again. Okay, now we got exactly what we need. So that's it. So now we want to take 3 render passes for our final comp image. So first one is color pass, second one is occlusion pass, third one is Z depth pass. So before that, we want to change our render settings. Go to render settings. So in common tab here, you need to set preset to full HD. So HD 1080. So like this. So now I want to adjust this camera view over here. So go to view, select camera. So now I select all the values over here, right click and choose unlock selected. Unlock selected over here. So now I want to adjust my camera view like this. Don't show the sofa top part because we not model that one. So because we want to hide that one, so we want to hide that camera view over there. So I will hide like this. So that's it. Now we select camera. So select the all the attributes in camera, right click and choose lock selected. So that's it. Now we want to render 3 layers. So go to render layer. So go to outliner. So now you want to select all the magnify glass group and control select match group and control select the polyplane 1 and control select the sofa group. So and then you want to select the direction light, spotlight. So don't select this reflection. So you want to select reflections also, all polyplane over here. So you want to select all the objects on all the lights in first layer. So all the object and all the lights selected, you want to click this button. So create new layer, assign selected object. So click this one and rename this layer as a CLR. So that means color. So now you want to only select the objects. So I will select my magnified glass group one, match group one, and sofa group one, and polyplane one. So for this objects, don't select any light and this polyplane, all these three polyplanes. So you want to only select the this option. So magnify glass, match group, and this wall and floor, and sofa group. So click this button and click over here. So here you need to choose OCC, that means occlusion. So now right click on occlusion layer and choose attributes. So go to preset. So sometimes the occlusion pause will not came. So go to channel box and layer editor again. So right click and choose attributes, preset, and choose occlusion. So click this little checker box, little arrow over here. So little arrow. So now you want to click give samples at least 64 and max distance up to 5. So you want to give samples to 64 and max distance to 5. So now select same thing over here. So select all the things in occlusion layer. So click on this button. So this one is Z minus depth. So it's a deep Z depth. Right click and choose attributes and go to preset. So sometimes it will not came. So that means you want to go again. So right click and choose preset and go to preset and choose luminance depth. So now we want to set minimum and maximum value of our render layer over here. So see here, so I will forget one thing. So go to channel box on layer editor. So select my color pause. So see here, I will leave this area over here. So don't show any edge options over here. So go to view and choose select camera. So I will select all the attributes, right click and choose unlock selector. So I will move this one. Don't show any edges on outside. So now I lock this layer, lock this all values. Now select the Z depth pause. So here we cannot see anything. So go to shading and choose wireframe on shader. So that means you will able to see the wireframe. So now we will right click and choose attributes, preset. So sorry, right click attributes, preset, and luminance depth. So here click this out color option. So here we have to set old min and old max. So it depends upon your scene from our camera. So it depends upon your scene size. So you want to set this as manual. So we want to calculate this scene distance from the camera. So I will select this matchstick over here. So go to window. I will select this lens. Now go to window, display, heads up display, and you want to select the object details. So that means it will shows. So don't see here, we want to see in camera view. So here you need to see its distance from the camera of 34 something. So that means, so here right click and choose attributes. So click on this material override, this checker box, arrow, and go to out color. Click on this arrow. So now in old min, you want to set this value. So right click and choose break connection. Here you need to set 34. So I will give only 34. If you have some other values, you give that one. So it's depend upon our scene distance. If you have different value, enter that one. So I will click this sofa over here. So it is 46. So I will go to layer editor. So right click and choose attributes. So click this arrow and click this arrow. So right click and choose break connection. So in old max, so my case the sofa is the depth, so it's a long, it's in Z depth. So I want to select my sofa, so it will give 46. So I will give a round value of 45 in old max. So that's it. Now we want to render. So select the color pause, select this view and click render. Okay, so now I got my render view over here. So it's perfect. So I want to save this image. So go to file and give save image option box. So I reset my settings. In default it will save as raw image. So we want to comp in Photoshop. So I want to save color management image. So and apply and close. So you want to choose this one. Now go to file and give save image. So in your images folder, this is a color pause. So I will give CLR. So and save. So now I select my occlusion pause and select this area. So select this view and click render again. Okay, now we want to save this image. Go to file and choose save image option box. So you want to set this one. So now go to file, save image, and this one is the occlusion. So I will give OCC in your images folder. So now we want to render our Z depth. So I will select this one, click over here and click render. So see here, when I click on Z depth pause, it will render as a Maya software. So it will only render as a in software render. So you want to smooth this object before you take render pause in Z depth. So I will close this one. I will select this object over here. So and go to mesh and choose smooth option box, and you want to choose smooth exponential and give one division to one. So now click this view and click render again. You want to smooth that object. So now you got this render report over here. So it will be perfect. Now go to file and give save image. So it's a Z depth. Okay. And give save. So you definitely want to smooth the object and then render. Okay. For our Z depth. So that's the end of our lighting part. So in next part, we want to comp in Photoshop.
Please click the below link to learn part 4 composition.